214, I think this is the most accurate because these are the two players I would think of. Keanu Neal and Tony Pollard.
Yeah.
And when I originally looked at this, Reggie, I was like, man, you can't have more than Tony Pollard on your roster because my feeling is you don't have a good enough depth at defensive line to say that you don't need extra roster spots for him. You don't have good enough depth on the offensive line, especially with your starters, to know that you won't need those roster spots for backup offensive linemen in the middle of a game. So my feeling was initially you can only have this one guy that isn't a starter but can do all these other things, and that would be Tony Pollard for me because you have to add those extra roster spots for your defensive line and your offensive line. But then when I hear Neal, I start thinking about all the things that they want him to do and who else on the team is capable of that right now.
There's a high possibility of it being the case.
Can we hold off on just 1 second and talk about Tony Pollard for just another second?
All right.
Is I immediately thought of Tony Pollard when we went through numbers 2 and 3, because I think that's what everyone's dream scenario is what it turns into. Because you already feel like Tony Pollard can catch the football, but with how much we get texts about him being a lead back, I think that's their dream.
I was surprised how good he actually is in between the tackles last year. But then whenever he bounces outside, he still has explosive 10-yard pickup capability, 15-yard pickup capability.
And I think that's those flashes are what give people the – I'm not saying he's going to be Alvin Kamara, but it gives people the dream of, hold on, and he doesn't make any money?
But look,
let's do that. Yeah,
but look at what happened with Kamara and McCaffrey when overused.
They got hurt.
Injuries, less production.
Yeah.
Like Mark Ingram leaves. The great thing about Mark Ingram and Alvin Kamara was fresh legs. You know, now you got fresh legs to rock with. And McCaffrey, same way. You had multiple other guys in the mix in that backfield with him, but you could use him in so many different ways. But then when you say, okay, now it's your responsibility to do all this stuff too, and you're getting even more reps, then it becomes, well, now you've put that body, you've compromised that body. And so that's why I like Pollard in the role if Zeke can live up to what he's supposed to do. I think people are tired of Zeke.
More than they love Tony Pollard?
They're just like, well, Zeke keeps fumbling the ball. Get him off the field. Put Tony Pollard in.
Right.
And I think that's where I get that. I get that totally. But that's when I'm afraid of overexposing his body to what the Cowboys typically do anyway. The Cowboys are like, let's run a running back into the ground.
All right. And so sorry to jump in there, Reggie. I just want to talk about Pollard for a little bit longer. All right, hit me up. Let's hear what we got, because there's a couple other suggestions coming in.
Yeah, and I think I saw the suggestion come in as well. But because of what we heard on draft night, I think that Michael Parsons is one of those guys that might be viewed as that. One of the things that we heard, we learned that, you know, he did some pass rushing and that he did not have a lot of time with that middle linebacker position yet. So I think that the idea, and we've heard it from like Broadus when he's been out at, you know, rookie minicamp and learning these things, is that they've rushed him off the end and that, you know, obviously
Tank
you
told him to get him in there.
Exactly. He's tapped in with Tank and stuff like that. So you expect him to be a middle linebacker. But, you know, he might be able to rush off the end and they might move. I mean, just generally, it seems like they might move him around and have him do different things.
I don't know how much they'll want him in coverage. I'm sure offenses will look to try to get him there.
Yeah.
But I feel like he is at the this year, at least they want him focused on what's in front of him, not what's potentially getting behind him.
What do you think about, because I've seen several people mention CeeDee Lamb from the 806. He can go slot, he can go outside, he can return punts, and then they talked about using him as the running back on like your end arounds and sweeps and stuff.
I'm against it, but Mike McCarthy, when he said you never graduate from special teams, which is a lie. Like it's a lie, cuz you know most of the guys that are on special teams are your backups. There are a couple of guys that are not, but
love to see Patrick Mahomes break a wedge.
Wait, we're still allowing wedges?
If he can, like if CeeDee Lamb can get the ball and be that guy, I don't think he's Dez as a returner.
Okay.
Dez was a different guy to me, but I just don't want to risk his playmaking ability. But I'll let the Cowboys do what they want to do. I do like the idea, though, Kevin, of presenting it as it's all competition. You know, like everybody that gets a job earns it. not, well, that's the only job we had for you, so we put you there. Or, well, you're the only person to put there. I want everybody to earn that job, and if he's the best at it, give him that job because he needs to.